Hello, I'm Emilia Amaro. I hope you already have met, and you have seen my previous part of the topic of dating, like trans, and find it interesting. Of course, I only can say my story, but if you have your story which you would like to share, or any opinion about online dating or dating, please write it down and let it, I will read it because I'm care. I really like other ones' journey to know about. So let's talk about the traditional dating experiences of mine one, like trans. I have just said in my previous videos I was once for in a bar, and that was pretty nice. I really liked it. There was a moment which I guess it's good to tell when we actually exit from the bar. Yeah, I was already a little bit drunk. I was wearing a black leather dress. Yeah, a pretty short one. With the high heels boot, is also leather. And there was a guy, a pretty handsome one, who asked me for for a light. I was shocked. So yeah, I have no practice anymore in dating. I was frozen down in a second, mostly because the guy was handsome and I could be really interested in. And he, there was nothing aggressive in his behavior, so he really showed attraction. And I was shocked. You know, after I don't know how many years, it have never happened that spontaneous to try for me a guy to approach. I couldn't manage the situation, and I can imagine how it looked from his side, the story. I guess he talked like crazy. And the guys with who I went, my ex and my host, no, my guest, was answering and finally managed the situation, but it was strange. I mean, what I did was strange. And I know it was because it was so unexpected. I was really have fun, but I had no idea anyone could have the bravery and courage to try to approach me. Yeah, and in a way it's strange because when before COVID I went regularly for the Italian course. I really like to do that because on mass transit usually I took bus. Guys was attracted for me, and once it happened, one guy wanted to approach me. It because of other reasons it couldn't happen, but the situation was pretty clear, and the guy was pretty handsome, so I could prepare myself. I don't know why I didn't. I didn't validate myself good enough, it seems, still. I mean, yeah, it's again strange because I'm always talk time looking good. Sorry, maybe it looks like I have a big head. But with my look, I not really ever had problem. Still, I have a kind of blockade in myself when someone who I'm attracted into, and that's only happened when I find the other ones attractive, I'm frozen. Really, I'm frozen. I could not say a word. I freeze, sorry. So, yeah. And the other experience which I had, because I tried to answer discotheque, I told, I was in concert because one of the hotel had a really great series every weekend. They had invited musicians from all around the world, and mostly jazz and so on. And I really love live music, and that was a great opportunity to go out. And that's a pretty fancy place, so that was my age. I mean, the ones who I'm looking for, but there I always went with my ex, so it was a kind of, maybe makes a kind of impression we are a couple, and like this, you know, no one approaching. So that was all, and yeah, it comes online dating. I started actually pretty early in the transition, before I was single for a long time, but other reasons I didn't really look around, and yeah, I guess it's a kind of combination can work, because of course the date target is to meet with someone, or I think. And with online dating, I find out it's pretty good to have met with someone who thought maybe I'm a woman, but I can make the disclosure straight up front. Or that latest, when they ask my phone number, usually I do like this. So I let them a kind of chance to know me if they normal, because sex predators, I'm not interested, I'm sorry. And I find that I'm not good in one night stand, because that's not give me really the possibility to enjoy. And so I'm not looking for that. So it's better online dating to have time, you know, if we have common topics, if we have the sense, you know, to communicate. Like, I like to make jokes, and I like teasing, and I like to talk erotic. If they understand, that's already half in. Because in my experience, there are people who are not into. But for me, it's really important part for any kind of relation or connection. So that's already makes a sieve, a filter in who I can be interested. And then comes, I make my disclosure. And yeah, there guys, usually the young one, the really pretty one, who immediately, sorry, I'm not into. And I said, no problem. It's not on the bucket list. You not must to try something. Because there's the possibilities. So they put, and they said, yeah, they like women genital, and they sorry. And I said, no problem. And that's all. Who really would like, because of curiosity, to try out? Usually already I filtered out with this filter of conversation, because they also not have most of them, and that's also always extraordinary examples who also in young age they can do this, but it's usually better with other who has some experience. So most of them are really not into, they just in the physical act. And they don't understand yet what's the difference between emotionally heated up or physically. So these guys are usually not that. Also, if they find me after that by curiosity interesting, it's not work out, because comes the problem, the date. You know, I like to be managed like other humans. I really like traditional dating, and that's also because of safety. So I like to meet with public place, usually not in the night time, when I have all this problem which I have said in my previous video. And they don't want because, yeah. They don't want to show for anyone. They have maybe curiosity in me because in their mind, you know, I'm stealing away a man. But it's all right. So this kind of connection ends pretty fastly, and well, because it's better for everyone. And as guys who not really open but curious, and they asking me about usual question, which usually pretty pivot question, and all the time the same I can say. So I have made a video with answers of mine one for them, because sometimes it's pretty annoying, you know, you get always the same questions, so that's not fascinating me at all, so I try to avoid that part. So they can me watch on the video, and if they have really curiosity and they can speak English, because not of course, then I answer. And they can think on. It's happening sometimes, months pass and they are coming back, pick in touch again and try to find out they are really interested or not. But that's usually nice because they watch me in them like a person. Which is, yeah, I'm a person, but yeah, we know, we are trans are fetishized. So that can happen, and when I'm answering for other specific questions which they have, I'm always said I'm like a public service. Because I give them the knowledge with not really any expectation, only to have them to understand. So, a kind of ambassador of trans women. And as guys who are absolutely not shocked or already had suspicions, or they already had experience with transgender, I usually really happy if it's like this because I don't have to explain everything and they have a kind of overview about things and they not worry. So it's really nice, you know, when your partner staff confident and know what he can expect. I mean, he has some idea about transgenders. So then I try to fix up an actual date, and at the moment it's really problematic in lockdown. I cannot say I don't look for festivities. But yeah, now at the moment it's stuck like this. But for the first contact, I really prefer online surfaces because it's kind of safe for us. And if you make your disclosure there, you can avoid transphobia in person and face with in person and maybe violent fact. I guess now I mix the stop for today again, and I would like to talk about the trans the this part of dating, the transphobia, the next time. And if you liked my video, thumbs up. If you're interesting, how is going forward with me after set up a date online, or what's my experiences coming back tomorrow, and have a nice day. And I hope you will have some information which you can use and have fun. We are single. Okay, not everyone, but who is interested in dating, I guess, single. Bye bye.